Meet Olive Dickason, renowned journalist, Aboriginal historian, single parent, grandparent, and author. As a middle-class girl growing up poor during the Depression, she had no idea she would come to change the face of Canadian history. But she did. Her books, huge and encyclopedic in their scope, are Canadian bestsellers, and they're changing the way Aboriginal and non-Aboriginal people view their history and their country.
When I think of Olive Dickason, I'm thinking of a person such who is a leader, an academic, a historian, a person of unique value, bringing together the non-Aboriginal world with the Aboriginal world and making the next generation a little bit more fundamentally aware of our true history, of the contribution of Aboriginal people.
Non-Native people tell their history from their perspective. They have not been in our boots to tell our particular side. That's one of the wonders of the magic and the importance and the significance of Olive Dickason's work, is that she's telling it from our perspective.
And that's how she was able to write a PhD about Canada's First People. This had never been done in the country before, as I say, because First Nations were beyond history. They were prehistorical. And she has brought them into the mainstream of Canadian history.
She wanted to immortalize our history, who we are, where we came from, where we might be going. That, to me, was her real intent. But inadvertently, she is more immortalized.